essential travel has priority. Non-essential travel will be worked out in the framework of the two ministries.
Christine Tushabe, a Ugandan from Bageza sub-county in Mubende district, got stranded at the Katuna border. She was traveling to Rwanda through the border, accompanying a relative for a burial ceremony across. Despite having all the necessary requirements, Tushabe was told by the authorities that Ugandans were not allowed to travel across.
Uganda, mva mu Mubende district. Era ekisinzo okunyiza nga bomanyero omuntu wabafiridwa omuntu we. Kitufu toba musanyufu. Tuze nga tumanyi nti tujja kutambula bulungi kubanga babadde batusuubiza nti ensalo bazigula wulimbu. Naye tugenze otuukawo nga ffe Bannayuganda tetukkirizibwa okukola ki? Okusala okudda ewaana.
Abdul Ndilima, a businessman from Kabale town who was going to Kigali to visit his relatives, said that despite the glitches which were yet to be solved, he will abide by the orders.
Rirwe twa turi kuza Kigali bisi hacyarimu ubuntu bucyaburaburamu tibari kutushobororeraje. Mwenu nizo turi nzira kuri iki baratushoborere tukagumiza mu twaza Kigali.
Bari kubagamba ngo nje ubuntu nibo babagambira ucyabura.
Uko handi Rwanda tikahagamba bako tikakiriho biso kubagira ati bacyarize byaturera ati kandi bari nzira kubanza nabo bakwatagana na ba Rwanda hine byo barasa kwikiriza na bamara meeting nibwe turamanye cyo baratugamba.
Ebo Bizmana, the Chisoro District LC5 chairperson who was at the Katuna border, expressed dissatisfaction on why Ugandans were not freely crossing to Rwanda, yet a statement was clear that the border is open.
They allow planes to move between countries, and we don't allow ordinary people to move across simple borders like this. Does it mean that only rich people who can travel by plane are the ones who are allowed to go and do other business? Other than then another thing is, I want at least another thing to happen. Make sure tourism opens. We are in the season of tourism, and of course tourism trucks have not been moving. So out of so many essential things people are talking about, I want tourism trucks and our boys who are doing tourism guiding and companies, let them be treated like cargo.
At around 11:30 a.m., Ugandan officials led by Ebo Kagumire, the commissioner in charge of customs from the Uganda Revenue Authority, and officials from the Immigration Department at Katuna border held an hour-long closed-door meeting with Rwandan security authorities. When asked what transpired in the meeting, Kagumire said that they were harmonizing on steps to follow while clearing the cargo trucks. He said that the meeting did not involve discussion about why it is still not easy for Ugandans to freely cross to Rwanda like it used to be.
That they are able to expand Katuna one-stop border. It used to be a small house there at the entrance. Now, within 2 years, if you have already finished the freight house and the offices were already occupied, and you're just left with just a road which trucks will go, I don't think we are unprepared. We are ready, and we are even saying trucks can still pass because the contractor is on site and can always move the trucks, and they have done already a traffic flow management that is going to guide the trucks as they go.
The two countries are giving priority to cargo trucks as more engagements continue. Ministry of Health officials from both countries are working on modalities that would ease travel for their citizens. Fabrice Sonwaswa, a Ugandan private cosmetic dealer who sells his stock in Democratic Republic of Congo, was the first truck driver to cross over to Uganda through the Ugandan-Rwanda point early Monday. Having arrived at the Gatuna border point, Waswa took long in the clearance exercise, and at 2 p.m. he made his way to Uganda. As more trucks were still arriving to cross the border, locals are expressing mixed reactions to the partial reopening of Katuna. Report by Job Namanya for the news.